waiting for one more person, but they're stuck in traffic. There's a festival apparently, so we're waiting for Gauri Shinde. She'll be joining us shortly. Okay, Sonali, so let's start with you. First up, how did Share the Load movement start? What urged Ariel to be the brand to speak about gender disparity at home?
That's a great question. Firstly, a good evening to all of you, and thank you for taking the time to come to this event. Actually, Ariel is a brand which has always been associated with progress. Actually, very early in the 90s when it was launched. It was the first laundry brand which actually featured husbands doing laundry. And we always know the product. The product is great. And with Ariel, actually, anybody can get really great laundry results, right? Whether it's your son, it's your husband. But what we really thought was, in today's world, brands have come a little bit further than just about selling the product and the product benefit. Brands such as Ariel have a huge influence on the society. And they need to be. I think it's a moral obligation almost, when you are that powerful or influential as a brand, to be a force for good, you know, to make a change in the society and use that influence to actually make a change. So that spirit is what actually got Ariel to start from the laundry, but really take the conversation closer home and talk about disparity at home.
Wonderful, wonderful job done there. And I think the ad film, which we will see a little later in the course of the evening, speaks about something which is so significant. And the fact that brands can put their might behind creating social change is so significant. Josie, next question for you. Would you throw some deeper light on the issue of conditioning and prejudice that Sonali spoke about? What has the Share the Load journey been like?
In terms of what, the perspective, or what do you mean by...
So let me rephrase that. How did this idea spring to your mind? What triggered this in you?
Okay, great. So, you know, I don't work alone. I work with a wonderful team who's sitting there. I work with amazing people like Sonali. Yeah, and the beautiful thing about our process is that normally you say in an ad agency, it's about, the client gave you a brief. So it's not about that. It's about a briefing, which is that you don't just say some transactional brief. It's a sort of circular process of discussion. Okay, so that's where it began in 2015. And we always say that content is king, but context is King Kong. Yeah. So for us, it was about the context. And there was that moment in time when we felt that a brand, as Sonali said, could make a difference. And we found this very interesting sort of fact or research point. We said that Indian men were probably among the lowest in helping out in household chores. And we said, maybe we guys as a brand could help make a difference, because laundry, that's the easiest way to start. And so we did this campaign which said, why is laundry only a woman's job? So it was a question. It was a question that was open for debate, you know, because who are we to say this is it? We said, let's create a platform for the world to exchange notes. And when we did that, we got an incredible response, and we knew we had touched something deep.
Massive research went into it as well.
Yes,
Take it, huh? Okay, so we were discussing Share the Load campaign, yes. And I was just asking Raj that, coming from where Josie left off, do you think that, you know, we all have this game face on most of the time? You know, we all pretend to be cool and very gender neutral or gender agnostic. Do you think that within our metro society, this still persists? How much of this is a reality?
It does. I'm pretty sure of that. Though, as I was telling you earlier, it's changing. It's definitely changing. But I think it is still a long way to go. I would like to actually men present here. आप में से कितने लोग हैं जो अपने घर के काम में help करते हैं? Honestly बताना. हाँ? See, it's changing. That's what I said. और आपके दोस्त लोग सब करते हैं? नहीं, बहुत लोग जो नहीं करते हैं ना. उनको बोलिए प्लीज ये एड देखें, है ना, और स्प्रेड करें इस कॉज को बहुत ज़रूरी है. But yeah, coming back to your question, it is changing, but I think it's still a long way to go because I travel so much, you know, we both travel so much. We go to a lot of small towns. And also I believe like India lives, you know, in its small towns. That's where the majority population live. And that's where the change also has to start. And I'm very thankful to, you know, PNG and Ariel that you guys are doing this campaign, and it's a great initiative, and we both are really proud and happy to be a part of it in some way or the other. Because I've been seeing it since like my childhood, not in my house, because my mother was somebody who believed in equality. But my friend's place, I come from Gurgaon, it's a small town. I've seen patriarchal society, and I used to feel very bad since I was a kid. But I'm glad there are people like you who are, you know, taking that initiative to change people's perception and people's thinking. It all actually comes down to conditioning, you know, the way we've been conditioned. And it all starts at your own house, in your own house. So things has to start changing from there. And I'm very, very hopeful that with this campaign, people will start changing their thought process.
Yep, well put. So since Ariel has been working on this idea on a Share the Load theme for a while, how far do you think the change has come from 2015 when you first launched the initiative?
Yeah, actually, we started the first film in around 2014-15, and we actually at that time we did a survey, as Josie pointed out, and what we wanted to assess is what is the social sentiment, what's really happening out there. So we went to four cities. We had Nielsen, actually not we, but we commissioned a survey from Nielsen. They went and they checked that 79% of the men then thought that household chores were only a woman's job. So 79% आदमी जो हैं वो ये ऐसे सोचते थे कि घर का काम सिर्फ औरतों का काम है. उस समय 2014 में जब ये हमने सर्वे कराया था नीलसन से, ये हमने रिपीट कराया. वी रिपीटेड दिस सर्वे इन 2016. एट दैट टाइम द नंबर वॉज 63%, एंड वी डिड इट राइट नाउ, एंड द नंबर ऑफ मेन हु थॉट दैट लॉन्ड्री इज ओनली अ वुमन्स चोर इज एक्चुअली नाउ 52%. सो यू कैन सी देर इज अ सिग्निफिकेंट चेंज, राइट? सिग्निफिकेंट चेंज. I'm very happy that there is a campaign like this, and there have been many others who joined actually the cause. We're not now the only brand, we started it, but there are many others who joined this cause, and it has made a change. It's a slow change. Even now we are clapping, but imagine 52% of the men in India still think that laundry is only a woman's job. So there's a lot more that we have to really accomplish going forward.
Josie, why do men evade household chores? Why?
It's sounding like very personal, eh? The way you said it. Yeah? Can you hear me without a mic? Wow.
Josie, why? Why do men evade household chores? You answer on behalf of all the men today.
Yeah. With bowed head and humble sort of vibes. Well, I mean, it's really something that we began in 2016. You know, when we spoke about 2015-14, it was really stating the condition. And then what we did was we looked at the root cause. And the root cause was the conditioning, like where are we coming from? And you realize that you're coming from everything that you see in your home. And what we try to do with both what we did in 2016 and today is revisit that conditioning and see that with that, you know, awareness of that conditioning, can we change things? Can we rearrange things? Can we point to that conditioning, create some enlightenment and revelation in the people who are responsible, maybe, you know, in their own way, not meaning to hurt anyone, and say, listen, there's another way to do it. So it's really that. So it's deep rooted in our conditioning, which is over several centuries, and slowly PNG is trying to change that. Yeah, so that's really what it is. I don't know. Maybe I should be saying I rather than we. God knows.
No, very well spoken. Gauri, what do you think is the implication of the Share the Load movement, and what happens when men don't share the load, or we don't share the load?
First is, your question was, what are the implications of if we share the load, right?
We don't.
If we don't share the load.
No, sorry, my question is, what are the implications of the movement, you think?
Correct. I think it's a very positive, having a positive impact, and that's what the intention was, and that's what it should be. And I think it is, and I think even men react very positively to something like this. I mean, there are two men right here, and I'm sure it's not just lip service, you all believe in this.
Yeah, so blood group be positive.
So, I think just as, and it was such a beautiful insight, and let me go back to where I was brought in, and when I was like so struck by this thought, and it was actually an eye-opener that, oh my God, this is the root cause, and it is the root solution also, is to tackle where it is. It's not about targeting men directly, but to gently, any kind of change requires a sort of gentle approach. People don't really respond well to a high-handed, heavy-handed, or some kind of preaching in that sense. So this really hit home, you know, and it has hit some chord. And it's about, like I'm repeating, that it's not about targeting men, but it's just targeting us as a whole, both the genders, that where we are probably getting it wrong, and that conditioning has, we are a product of our conditioning, and at some point we need to question that status quo. Like, this is not really working for most parties, and for women it is not. And I think that is what the biggest impact is. As the mothers are enabling their women, their daughters, to actually be independent and ambitious, same time, what the movement is trying to say is enable the men too. It cannot be this lopsided growth where only the women move forward, but how will they move forward if this part doesn't move forward as well? So I think it's a very important movement.
I think what was really interesting, or maybe I'll save that for when people have seen the film, and we'll discuss that in a bit. Raj Patra, Patra, particularly you, I know you're very outspoken and you will speak your mind. And Raj
and
is
hearts.
now and heart. And Raj is now looking a little worried, and he's like, "Kya puchne wali hai ye Patra se?" No, so we live in the same building, or used to anyway. So we're friends. So I can ask this. You know, amongst our circle of friends and people, isn't there this subtle patriarchy, idea of, we were discussing this earlier, that particularly at the dining table, you know, you see that men go and take their seats and women are quickly running around and serving, bringing hot rotis and, you know, "Acha kya khayenge, dal khayenge, ye khayenge, wo khayenge," whatever. So that idea of patriarchy, do you see it around you, yourself, in your circle of friends, which seemingly from the outside are cool and evolved on the level of gender?
So Tiska, hi everyone, good evening. I'll tell you where I come from. I'm from Meghalaya. So it is a matriarchal society. So initially when I had come to Mumbai, and back home, it's the food is heated, it's kept, you know. The clothes are being washed either by my mom or dad, which is not a rare sight at home. Papa also goes and serves dinner for us. Once I got here, like that's about 8-10 years back, it's the small things that I saw at my friends, my college friends' home, that everybody is seated on the table, including me, my friends, their pair, their mom, their dads, and auntie's not sitting because she has to serve us food, she has to make rotis for us, and she would be the last one to eat. So that was a bit weird, and that's when it struck me that there is a disparity. And I don't know, things hasn't changed as yet, because when we go out, you'll see that our friends are serving us food first and they are the last one to eat.
Interesting, huh? So Meghalaya is a
matriarchal society.
Yes. How lovely. But I'm,
yeah.
Yeah, ladki ke.
Really?
Is it true? Yeah.
And
okay,
what's funny is I come from a matriarchal society. I found a boyfriend who's from Haryana. And he is everything that we don't hear about. He's the one heating a food for me when our maid is not coming. Raj is...
Josie talked about actually this conversation that he had. It's about conditioning, right? And as we looked at the kinds of conditioning there are, you know, people, the kids, when they're growing up, they really follow what they see. And we started the conversation last year where we talked about how looking at what was happening at his daughter's place, the father realized how he had conditioned actually things at home because he wasn't sharing the load. And it was self-realization, right? The thing that we realized actually was that the same was happening as in with sons, that our mothers, you know, when they are actually, when they're looking at what you expect out of a son, they have a lot of things that they expect out of their daughters. So they say ki beti ko bahar jana chahiye, padhna chahiye, main beti ko padhaungi, likhaungi, and that change has happened. But bete ke liye aisa hota hai, beta bas paida ho jao, bas wahi kafi hai. Right? It's almost ki bas utna hi kafi hai, and there's not that much of expectation on what you want to actually, are you preparing your son for the daughters that you have raised, right? So what we see is, and it was a very interesting statistic that we saw, that 7 out of 10 women actually have had to step back from responsibilities at work, say something like a promotion, because they don't have the help at home that makes them confident that they can take that opportunity. And that's because we haven't reared our sons to be ready for the kind of daughters that we are raising. And that thought was what sparked us, that this time the question that we must be asking of us ourselves as a generation is, are we setting the right expectations also for our sons to be ready for the daughters that we are raising, right?
Wonderfully put. So, so wonderfully put. On that note, shall we see this much talked about, much loved film? You know what struck me watching it for the second or third time this evening is that in a very interesting way, the film is talking about the fact that you're elevating the son to reach the level of a daughter, and not to, so you're not actually showing household work down. You're not saying, oh my God, it's a horrible, nasty thing to do, and so one of us has to do it, and so who's going to do it? It's more the idea that it's our work, it's our pride, it's looking after ourselves, and, you know, sons should be elevated to the level of being able to look after themselves. And I think that's a wonderful, wonderful, subtle idea that you're saying, that, you know, we've not raised you to that level to be like a daughter, which is amazing. Okay, Gauri, let's start with you. You've always shown a very unique perspective of a woman through your films. What did you think about this little gem of an ad film?
What did I think about it? like I said earlier, like when Josie and his team and Hemant and Aarti, yeah, all they came to meet me and tell me this idea, I was blown. I was like, what a wonderful thought, and so delicately and so nuanced. You know, I mean, yes, a thought is one thing, and to actually sort of narrate it and screenplay it in this fashion was beautiful. I mean, to say something so powerful in such a gentle way, and to actually tap such a key insight. I mean, I was blown, and I had to do it, and I wanted to do it, and hopefully they're happy with.
And you know, we took our time, but she waited. She's a busy director, but she said, I give you time, and she gave us that time. Thank you.
That's not.
It is. I mean, it is truly, truly a very, very artistic piece of work. Very, very nice. As the creative mind behind this on the level of scripting, etc., from a male perspective, what were the various things that went in from your side into the making of this film?
Yeah, that's a great question. For us, one of the most sensitive points was that change point. How do we look at the son? How do we look at that relationship? You know, the son is a victim of conditioning. He's not a villain. So we had to traverse that in a way that was inclusive. We didn't want to put anyone off. This was not about divisionary forces. This was not us versus them. It's recognizing what is. And that sensitivity, I think, is what Gauri brought in. And for us, that change point was critical because we didn't want to be heavy-handed, sharp, black and white. Life is not black and white. There's a roundedness that we captured, and Gauri did that.
Excellent. On that note, we have...
Thank you.
मैसेज आया और अब भी मैंने भी देखा कि 15 मिलियन व्यूज मिले हैं तो दिस इज अ फिल्म
एब्सोल्युटली ओनली आई वुड हैव नोन कैसे फिल्म बना रही हैं वो और लड़का चाहिए तो मतलब मैं खुद ही उनको कॉल कर देता कि आई एम देयर कास्ट मी
व्हाट्स माय थॉट अबाउट शेयर द लोड आई हैव ग्रोन अप इन अ होम दैट बिलीव्स इन शेयरिंग द लोड I have a partner who believes in sharing the load. This shouldn't be a rare thing. I think everybody should do this because it's everyone's right.
हमारा जो प्रोफेशन है एक्टर होने का वो तो हमें लेना पड़ेगा लोड वो हमारे लिए कोई और शॉट दे नहीं सकता है बट अदरवाइज घर पे जो यू नो व्हाट पत्रा इज सेइंग एंड व्हाट गौरी मैम एंड सोनाली मैम दे वी आई ट्राइंग टू से इज कि घर पे जो काम है ये जो घर के काम है वो सिर्फ ऐसा नहीं कि सिर्फ एक यू नो फीमेल्स को औरतों को करने चाहिए ये सबकी जिम्मेदारी है ना ये सब जो एक पुरानी हम कंडीशनिंग चली आ रही है ना बहुत सेंचुरीज पहले के आदमी हंट करने जाता था औरत गाना बनाती थी वो नहीं हो गया अभी औरतें दे कैन हंट बेटर देन मेन सो आई थिंक इट्स टाइम टू ब्रिंग इन दैट चेंज
मैं अभी सब लॉन्ड्री अभी राजकुमार के पास भेज रही हूं बिकॉज़ ही हैज एग्रीड टू शेयर ऑल आवर
या प्लीज दे दो मैं चाय बहुत अच्छी बनाता हूं मुझे थोड़ा ओसीडी है तो मैं घर को एकदम साफ रखता हूं पर ऐसा नहीं कि पत्रा कपड़े फेंकती रहती है वो भी बहुत अच्छे से रखती है बट आई थिंक वी बोथ आर दैट्स व्हाई यू नो दैट्स व्हाट इट टॉक्स अबाउट इक्वालिटी कि दोनों मिलके it's your house it's not only somebody want like it's a family house a family has to run the house
good evening to you
good evening sir
hi does this disparity is limited to the household as we are talking about the professional disparity at the professional places also kya nidan ho sakta hai iska apart from taking ye jo initiative jis tarah se hum log le rahe
hain ji नहीं ऑफ कोर्स हो सकता है आई थिंक कोशिश वही है हम सबको आई थिंक आप सबको हम सबको हम सबकी जिम्मेदारी है कि हम वो इक्वालिटी से बात करें सबको यू नो घर ऑफिस में भी घर में भी एवरीवेयर आई थिंक ऑल अराउंड द वर्ल्ड वी हैव टू बिलीव इन दैट इक्वालिटी वी हैव टू वर्क टूवर्ड्स दैट इक्वालिटी आई थिंक दैट्स द ओनली वे टू हैव अ बेटर प्लेस बेटर वर्ल्ड
Parity as in wages. Yeah, I think that's the fight that's been going on from a very long time. And I am just starting off, so I don't think so I'm the right person to talk about this. I think Gauri ma'am is in a better position to talk about the disparity of wages. Than
yes, but ma'am. I think this is not the topic of the event, so I think we should stick to disparity in household, and that's what we're talking about. Not even disparity, it's the equality that we need of sharing the load. So I would like to stick to that.
Questions around campaign, please.
It's everything, sir. It's love, responsibility. It's the feeling of oneness, I guess. I think it comes from everywhere. It comes from upbringing, actually. Aapke jo upbringing jis tarah se hui hai, it comes from there, and that's the point our film is trying to make. You know, you have to start from your own family. Only then you can bring in that change.
And also, if it's my home, it's his home as well. So if I have to do the cleaning, he also is equally, I'm working, he's working. Like my sister lives in the States, so they don't get much time to clean up the house, so they divide. So my sister cuts vegetables, my Jija cooks. My sister washes the clothes, my Jija cleans the house. So it's our house and we need to make that initiative, and then only I guess we'll be happy. I think ये कपड़े भी अच्छे से धो लेता है जब क्योंकि उनको OCD तो
है।
अभी देख रहे हो?
अच्छा नहीं, बहुत जल्दी।
नहीं नहीं, हम इस बारे में बात करते हैं ना।
बहुत जल्दी। किसने बोला है?
No,
I have no idea. I think when the right time comes, you will get to know about it. अरे रोज वैलेंटाइन्स डे होता है यार. यही क्या थिंग यार प्यार बांटते चलो बस.
We celebrate love every day, so it's not one specific day that we have. I think we should celebrate love and life every day.
Love is for life, yeah.
Gauri ma'am, are you क्या question है?
What are you doing for Valentine's Day? कहाँ पालकी सर को लेके जा रहे हैं?
तो specific कोई planning है Valentine's Day के लिए and rose को share किया आपने?
आज rose day है?
देखो पता ही नहीं है.
पता भी नहीं था तो मैं एक rose लेके जाऊँगी किसी के लिए. अच्छा तो इधर होंगे ना फूल फॉर वैलेंटाइन्स दैट प्लीज वॉच दिस फिल्म बिकॉज वैलेंटाइन्स डे इज ऑल्सो अबाउट लव एंड शेयरिंग सो आई थिंक दिस फिल्म ऑल्सो इन अ वे इज अबाउट लव एंड अबाउट केयरिंग फॉर ईच अदर एंड दैट वुड बी माई मैसेज That share the load. That would be my message. That men and women share the load, share your responsibility, share the love. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
For Bollywood news update, please subscribe our YouTube channel Bollywood Dangle, and please don't forget to press